conveners of the inter-party resistance against the new voters register say they will remain resolute in their stance until the Electoral Commission reasons with them. A large number of protesters took to the streets of Kumasi in a demonstration dubbed Yempene, to wit, we won't agree. A report by William Evans Nkum.
Over 1,000 aggrieved members of some opposition parties embarked on the protest march. They held placards bearing inscriptions to echo their grievances. Most of them targeted the Electoral Commission, but the government was also not left out of the attack. They chanted songs to energize their stance on the yet-to-be-compiled voters register. At Abuabo, a standoff ensued between the protesters and the police, but normalcy was swiftly restored. Chairman of the People's National Convention Party, Bernard Mona, described the Electoral Commission as autocratic.
Any attempt to bring any new register in the face of all the suspicions and tensions will lead this nation into calamity.
To Hassan Ayariga, leader of the APC, they remain resolute in their stance.
I think that gradually we are achieving the aim to be able to register our displeasure to Ghanaians and the EC, to know that many Ghanaians are not for the compilation of a new voter register.
General Secretary of the NDC, Johnson Esiedun Keita, wants the EC to reason with the aggrieved parties.
We are fighting a war of common sense. There is assault on reasoning in this country, and we think that we must rise up to defend common sense and defend reason.
Director of Elections for the NDC and the party's representative at the IPAC, Elvis Efriye Ankra, expects a change of mind from the EC at the next IPAC meeting.
What we're doing is to save the little credibility that the EC has left, because if you have an electoral system or an electoral commission, that loses its credibility completely. It portends danger for our democracy.
Let's just say a bit further on this, and joining us on the telephone is independent presidential candidate in the 2016 general elections, Jacob Oseyeboah. Mr. Oseyeboah, good evening to you, if you can hear me. Thank you for your time this evening. This particular group, that's the Inter-Party Resistance Group Against the New Voters Rule, have indicated that they are suspending any further demonstrations or protest because of this advice by the eminent persons. Are you looking at this achieving consensus going forward?
I think that is the best route that I think we need as a nation. We need to build consensus. But the issue had to do with how we tend to understand the position of EC as an independent body, and the reasons that EC has alluded to for this new biometric voter register. And I think that, when our hearts cool and then we turn to reason, we will all come to the conclusion that indeed EC is on the right path, and that all of us as Ghanaians should support EC for this new biometric voter register. And so if the demonstrators now say that because of the advice of the eminent advisory committee of EC, they are suspending their demonstration, it's all well and good. Because I find it very, very difficult to really assert now to understand their position, why they are against, after all what EC has actually come out with the information available to the public now, for which I myself knew that these same demonstrators, most of these political parties, or all of them, they knew what the EC was doing. So it's all part of the political game. And it's well and good. Let's see how the whole thing pans out.
Well, one of the major issues is that the Electoral Commission is not engaging IPAC, you know, as has always been the case in previous instances. But then again, as you mentioned, the Electoral Commission is conducting its business as an independent body. But, I mean, what do you think this meeting that the eminent persons have proposed, the dialogue that they want the Electoral Commission to have with these parties will achieve, considering the stance that these two persons or groups have taken?
Let me put it on record that, you see, I find it very difficult when some parties at IPAC saying that the EC have not been engaging them with this new biometric voter register. In fact, I myself personally started attending the IPAC meeting from September or so. And then in our first meeting, EC mentioned about the savings over $20 million. I mean, that was the first time that I felt that EC brought the savings to the knowledge of IPAC. And there were a lot of questions. That was when the NGC and some other parties were asking EC for more details. And then EC said that in that meeting that, you know, they are accountable to Parliament and they've put this proposal before Parliament and they have to wait until they've had feedback from Parliament before this information could be made available to us. And one of the things that I, in particular, experienced on the 25th, the November IPAC meeting, that was when EC told IPAC that maybe early part of December, the shortlisted vendors will be demonstrating their services, right. And so they will be inviting us. And then I, in particular, started asking, when was this open tender? When was the tender closed? And they gave me answers. So something that IPAC, a process that IPAC started, right, which was advertising the dailies. Okay. How can the same people say that we have no knowledge of this?
Okay.
And so, in fact, my advice to the EC is that this impending meeting with the IPAC, EC, and the Eminent Advisory Committee, I would wish that they should also invite TV3, the media, and so that at least the meeting should be in-camera meeting so that all Ghanaians will know what will actually transpire in that meeting. So that at the end of the day, I think all of us will understand. Because to be honest with you, they will say that EC is wasting the public press.
I get the point.
EC has demonstrated that if they, it has to move with this monopolistic vendor, we are going to spend 173 million Ghana cedis more.
I think that's indeed a point well made there. I want to thank you so much for your time this evening. Extremely grateful. Jacob Oseyeboa is an independent candidate in the 2016 elections. Indications are that he's contesting in 2020 as well.